Oh, that's lame. You gotta go. Yole, 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 yole. Hey, we're on top of Georgia Pass. Came from that direction, I don't know, 85 or so miles into the CP. Hello, Carrie. Our feet hurt. I've got blisters. Yay. And yeah, we'll hit Breckenridge, which is out that way. See some ski resorts. It's awesome. Just past Zero Pass. It is August 17th. We took 2 zeros because of the storms. Really isn't all that much snow up here. It's beautiful though. We're refilling at a mountain stream without purifying because this water will taste better than our town water. Yeah, the peaks all around us have a nice dusting of snow. Really beautiful. It seems like it snowed at most about 5 inches. And the life says, hey, standing at Wirtz Ditch Road, just past Leadville. Just had an awesome bit of trail angeling last night in the supermarket. This guy overheard someone else offering us a ride out of Leadville to the trailhead and drove us up late at night, brought us beers, gave us some beers, and just chilled, had a nice long conversation with him. Turns out that he was a Forest Service Ranger out of Leadville, Adam, super nice guy. And then he met us just now this morning here and brought us maps and coffee in the morning to suggest this alternate, the Hope Pass alternate with some extra stuff added to it. So just a super nice park ranger. This is the area that we're at, nothing too remarkable, right near the 10th Mountain Division hut. Yeah, and coffee and maps and good company, nice guy.
I'm on top of Mount Elbert, which is the highest peak in Colorado. Going to be heading over that way, over Hope Pass and Elkhorn Pass, instead of doing the official Colorado Trail, because the CT has been staying super low and kind of boring in the forest and kind of used, and it's way cooler to be up here. Yes, that's the direction they're heading. That's the pass over that way. The summit area up here has bunch of different spots for people that want to sleep up here. The weather is good, which is pretty cool. Yeah, it's just beautiful. This is Mount Massive right there. We came through the forest down there, coming around on the summit ridge. There's Leadville, which is a cool mountain town. The lake I'm going to be heading down to today. Going to have lunch down there. It's still really early in the morning. It's 10 to 9 right now, and August 21st, and this is the summit register. This is the top of Hope Pass. That's Mount Elbert over there. Nice and flat up here. This is where the Leadville race comes. Nice view out into the Collegiate Peaks. And Mount Hope.
Hey, I'm on top of Elkhead Pass. Same day as I did Hope Pass. It's 1:30 now. I've been busting it pretty hard.
With only about a half hour break, surrounded by 14 acres. There's people all around. This is Mount Belford, and Oxford is back there. One of the routes you go up is right there. I probably could do it in, I don't know, 45 minutes to the top or something like that, really fast, but I don't really have the chance today because I need to make more miles to Durango. So, stunning spot. Really glad I came up here. It's not on the track.
Yeah, and I was getting super tired coming up. And I'm glad I'm here now.
The clouds are a little worrisome, especially that one right overhead. There were absolutely no clouds an hour and a half ago. I'm going to hurry up going down this way, trail down that Missouri Basin deserves its own video. It is amazing. Probably the coolest place I've been in Colorado so far. There's the pass.
Last night there was a bump in the night when we were asleep, and I woke up and I shook the tent because I thought it was a bear or an elk or something going after our food, and kind of went back to sleep for a little bit, and then there's another loud sound that I screamed at, and then this tree fell down right next to us, which isn't a very good thing. Yeah, if it had fallen just a little bit closer in a different direction, we would have been hit. We're on Sergeant's Mesa.
Almost died!
No! Yeah, it's a lesson in paying more attention to widowmakers, which is kind of hard to do because there's so many dead trees because of the pine bark beetles, but... yeah, so as you can see, it fell pretty close to us, and that was pretty scary. Yep.
Hey, I'm on section 18 of the Colorado Trail. That's the pasture flat section. It's known for being dry and having a lot of cows. It's actually really beautiful. I'm enjoying it. Walking along. All the way out there, came from that direction, some trees, there's just a little cabin back there. Yeah, that's about it. It's kind of the sound of the trail. My little fanny pack, I keep my iPod, my camera, hand sanitizer, my knife, my sunglasses. Yep, that's about it.